Good morning, beautiful people. It is another day in Panglao, Bohol, Philippines, and it's raining. I'm not sure if I should cancel my tour.
I'm going to go ahead and talk to the front desk and see what's going on, what is the plan. I doubt it if we'll be able to make it at 6 o'clock. It's raining outside. So this season usually not supposed to be rain in the Philippines. It's dry season, summer. But now it's raining a lot. They believe it's a climate change. So it is not happening only in the US, it is happening around the globe. I believe the climate change is real. I talk to the front desk and they say, yes, even if it's rain, we are going. I'm sure I'll be get wet. I already prepare myself. If it is get wet, no problem. I don't know, this is not sunny, man. I really want some sunny, beautiful day, full of cloud. This is a tropical place. It is always can happen. It is a kind of a magic sometime because all tropical places is rain, all of a sudden is sun. So that's probably gonna happen.
Let me show you in the map. I'm here in Panglao Island in Bohol, and I'm going to down that little dot. It's called Virgin Island. Let me take you there. Dolphins love to follow boats and show off their fastest swimming capability. Sometimes they steal fish from the fisherman's net. They're so smart. All the boats are slowed down because any sudden movement of boats, it could be accidentally kill or hurt the dolphins. The dolphins have incredible skills. Dolphins can be visible anytime, but early morning is probably the best time. Finally arrived in the Virgin Island sandbar. Don't get confused with the British Virgin Island, which is located in the Caribbean Sea. This island is located here in Bohol, Philippines. The Philippines is an archipelago. This means a group of islands which is together makes the Philippine Islands. It has 7,641 islands, and among those, only 2,000 are inhabitants, and the rest, 5,000, doesn't even have a name. No people lives there. Panglao to Virgin Island take about 20 minutes, maybe 25. But today take a little bit more time because we stop for the dolphin.
This is nice to walk in this water to the sandbar.
Baloney usually comes in a bigger shell. Tastes like a salty, little buttery, very similar taste to scallops. Wow, look at this. The sea cucumbers and the sea urchins. Sea cucumber tastes like a salty and crunchy. The sea urchins are like spiny, like porcupines. It does taste sweet and savory, almost like oyster. The black sea urchins taste different than the brown urchins.
Yeah, they can cook for you. How much you sell for fish?
This 500.
Pompano?
Yes. Pompano.
500. And squid. This? How about this?
800.
All kind of seafood is available here, including the aphrodisiac, and they cook for you.
These people open a small food stall on the sandbar.
Banana cue, it is deep fried or barbecued, coated with a brown sugar. It is the most common street food in the Philippines. Everybody tried it. It will be hard to find a Filipino guy saying, I have never tried banana cue. Cervezas, maybe I'll have some later.
She's enjoying food here. Nice. Hello. What are you eating?
We call it lato.
Lato? It's like a seaweed?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a seaweed?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Is it healthy?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. You from local?
Yeah.
Nice. Nice to meet you.
You're here.
Thank you. Actually, I would like to eat here some fish. Even I want to invite my driver. But the problem is, last night I wasn't able to change my money. And you cannot pay in the sandbar here a credit card, you know? Probably there is no Wi-Fi at all. So I don't have a cash enough to buy this fish and treat lunch for those two guys in the boat.
Abalone.
Abalone. Which one is abalone? Oh, those are abalone? Oh, yeah? Oh, wow, it's moving.
Yeah.
Is it like a shell?
Yeah.
Can I touch it?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh my God. Well, what kind of fish this one? Is this swordfish?
Swordfish.
They're cooking here. Rice, I guess. Here you go. Some ceviche. What do you call this? Kinilaw?
Yes, sir.
Ceviche.
Yeah.
Ceviche.
No.
Ceviche is Spanish, but this is has a fish in there.
Garlic.
No fish.
No fish.
Sea hot dog?
Yeah, because here in the sea.
It's a sea hot dog. So come from the sea.
Yeah.
It's like a seafood, huh?
Yes.
Look at this. See, hot dog is a red color. Of course, he's joking, we know that. How much you charge for squids? Squid, how much? Makano?
100.
100 for one?
One stick.
One stick, 100.
Yes.
It's like a $2. Yeah, almost, yeah.
Not for you, bad. Only 50 pesos.
For me, 50 pesos?
Yeah.
Each?
Yeah. One stick.
One stick?
Yeah.
Hold on, let me ask my driver, see if they want to join me.
Okay.
You take credit card?
No, no credit card.
Yeah, no credit card, only cash.
Only cash, only cash.
I need to find my boat and the capitan and the helper. I would like to invite them for squid barbecue. Okay, I found my boat. My captain and the helper is there.
I invite my driver and the captain and the helper. To try some squid here. I mean, if I had enough money, cash, I would probably have a good lunch here. Problem is, last night I arrived and the bank was, money change was closed. And next morning is my boat tour and I didn't have a chance. I think not the whole sandbar goes marsh under the water. Some part over there is still dry. Only this part here goes underwater. You see how many boats here?
This is a unique kind of trip. It's a natural thing. Local people set up a little food stall here. They work hard to bring all the way food here to sell it, to make some profit, which is understandable, of course. Okay, I'm back. My people is here. So let's say 50 each, right? Make it 1, 2, 3, 6. The squid, not the sea hot dog. Okay? No sea hot dog. You want the squid? Yeah. What kind of sauce you have?
Sauce? Vinegar or?
I will take the vinegar only. No bagong, okay?
Okay.
Separate, huh? This is my capitan.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Christopher.
Christopher.
Yeah.
And this is, what's your name?
Jumar.
Jumar?
Yeah,
Jumar and Christopher. And you?
Mario.
Mario, you're very tall. You should go to basketball. Oh, actually you are standing on the tool.
Very tall because you are
high.
What are you making?
Abalone.
Abalone, oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Chili garlic sauce.
Zumer, you Muslim?
No.
No? Christian?
Yeah.
Christian.
Okay, my squid is cooking here. What's your name?
Jerome.
All right. How they put this little barbecue things and on the bottom is the sand to make sure the boat don't get burned. And here's a stand. Stove, top of the wood. Here you go. Cooking here. Wow. We eat here?
Huh?
We're gonna eat here?
Swan?
No. We're gonna eat here.
Okay, no problem.
It's for VIP only.
Eat.
All right. Calamansi. Huh? Some calamansi. Put some more calamansi. Yeah.
You want vinegar here?
Small orange, huh? That's vinegar. Vinegar. Is it a Coca-Cola vinegar? Let me see. Yeah? I never know Coca-Cola make a vinegar.
Vinegar.
Oh, you put the vinegar inside. Oh, okay. Okay, I got some. Mmm. Fresh. Masarap.
Yummy.
Yummy. Masarap in Tagalog means delicious. In here, Bohol also masarap. Because in Legazpi say masaram. In Bicol. They don't say.
Sayan lami.
Lami?
Lami.
Is a Bohol under Bisaya? Yeah? So you do. Put some in a vinegar, dip it up like this. Memorable. Your sandbar is also in there too?
Yeah.
It's a circle. Is it one circle?
No.
Until
there. Up to there.
Yeah, it's deep.
Oh, deep. So only here. The boat, right?
Yeah.
You know, fresh squid, vinegar, tastes great. I haven't tried squid for a while. Do you know the squid, a Filipino language, what they call? Pusit. Pusit is a Filipino language, means squid. Okay, we're gonna drink some beer. Red Horse. This is a Filipino beer, Red Horse, and it's considered as a strong beer. Look at this. So we're gonna share this beer with my Capitan Christopher and his helper.
Very cold.
Oh, you have a cold one, huh? Oh man, that's what I'm talking about. I can afford 100 pesos, no problem. Right? Yeah, open it for me. And you have a glass?
Yeah, we have glass.
Okay. Okay. We're going to share this bottle of beer. Three people. Okay, so Jerome is pouring beer. Red Horse. You drink beer sometime?
Yeah, okay.
What is your favorite beer? San Miguel or Red Horse?
Tanduay.
Tandu, oh, that's strong. All right, so let's cheers. Christopher Zumer, right?
Kanpai.
All right. Cheers.
Oh, yeah, it is a cold beer.
It's really cold. Nice. I make my day here. Beautiful. Virgin Island sandbar.
My bill is 400 pesos. 100 pesos was for the Red Horse. And 6 pusit, which is 6 squid, was 300 pesos.
I gave him 1,000 pesos. That's all I have. But he doesn't have change. So he's going around now to find some change.
Lots of local Filipino people here. If there was no pandemic, then maybe many European tourists, other country American tourists is here. This place could be crowded. So one good thing is that in a pandemic time, not so many people here. So if you are able to make up to here in this place, great. I mean, it was difficult for me to get the pass, H pass, and all kind of form to fill it up, to get a permission to come to Philippines, especially when you're going to island to island. You need an S-Pass. And I do not know how long this S-Pass is going to be exist. Probably very soon we'll be remove it, because how long people going to be suffering with this kind of procedure, you know? So I'm happy that I'm this kind of place. I was able to make it.
This sandbar is beautiful. It has about 90% white sand and 10% brown sand mix. This is the first sandbar I have seen that you can walk on it in the water and also have a lunch at the same time. Book your tour ahead of time, avoid paying the higher price. Price could start as single person from 400 pesos up to 1,000. But if you have a private boat, then it could be go 1,500 to 3,000 pesos. Foreigners, price could be doubled. In the Philippines, any place you go, because they know that you are not local. If you go with the right people, right travel agent, then you don't have to pay the higher price.
By 11, probably everybody out of here. It's the only short-term food stall here. Between 6 a.m. until maybe 10. By 11, impossible to be here. It's, water is up to here. No food can be cooked here or sell. Then, at after 5 o'clock in the afternoon, it's okay again. Low tide, water goes away, and the sandbar pops up. However, it's not the only sandbar in the Philippines. There's some other sandbar around the world they have. You need to research a little bit where you can find this sandbar and go. Bohol is a great destination. I would say that if you come to the Philippines and you're planning to doing a island hopping, Bohol should be in your list. You take the flight from Manila to Panglao. I would recommend take the hotel probably near to Ilona Beach is better. My hotel is a little far away. I couldn't go change money or anything. So stay in Ilona Beach, probably much better. Hotel maybe a little bit more money, but it's a convenient. You can find jeepney, tricycle, transportation easily. My hotel, I have to walk about 10 minutes to go to the street. And then maybe if I'm lucky to find a tricycle or jeepney. So definitely when you go some places, don't be isolated yourself. But unless you want to be isolated, I mean, you would like to stay maybe isolated place because maybe you're writing a book or movie script. You don't want anybody bother you. You want to be a peaceful place. Then, yes, then you go isolated place. But for me, all day long I'm out from the hotel. I want to see places. In that case, it's the best way to do is stay near to the town. I'm a travel agent for 27 years. Many people ask me, so why you take the hotel that far if you knew you are a travel agent, you are experienced? Because when I see the hotel, it is on the beach, and that's the only hotel that I found on the beach. It was beautiful and peaceful. There is 10 minutes walk, and I say, you know what, that's fine, I'll walk 10 minutes, no big deal. So I purposely did it. It's not like you're out of touch from the world, it's okay.
This video about to be end. If you like my video, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon so you will get a notification. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in my next video.